What's up, everyone? It's Lexly Nirvana, and I want to give a shout out to The Urban Influencer, the number one platform for independent artists.
Absolutely, absolutely. How you doing there, folks, today? We got Lexly Nirvana, man. She is an awesome young lady in God, and it's about time, man. It's a trip, right? How sometimes you're trying to work things out to set up interviews and things like that, and you go through a little bit of, you know, obstacles and challenges, but finally, I'm so excited about this interview, Lexly.
Me too. Thank you so much for having me.
You're very welcome, because I've been following you, man, for a minute, and it was one of my goals to be able to interview you. So how you doing today, sis?
Doing great. Yes.
Beautiful. So let's see. I'm going to just ask you a few questions, if that's okay with you.
Yeah, no problem.
That's fine. Let's see. Tell everybody a little bit about yourself, okay?
So my name is Lexly Nirvana. I'm a Christian hip hop reggaeton artist. I'm based from Texas, South Texas. So we're like super close to the border.
Oh,
like,
wow.
Maybe like 15 minutes away.
Okay, wow.
Yeah, maybe like 15, 20. Yeah. I've been doing Christian music or Christian rap for maybe about 11 years now. So it's been a journey, and God it's been so good. Like when you give your talents to Him, He'll take you, like you don't even know. So it's been a journey, learning.
So you said you've been doing this for about, did you say 11 years? For about 11?
Yeah, like about 10, 11 years.
Beautiful. That's beautiful. Wow. And so are you're just a strictly CHH artist, or?
Yeah, I've been doing it for yeah, I've been doing CHH, and now I've been doing more Spanish now as well.
I'm
trying to represent my culture.
Yes, I love that. I wish I was bilingual, man. That's a beautiful thing. So, you know, I was reading a little bit up on your bio, Lexly, and I see that you started something at a pretty young age. Can you share what that was? I think like at age 19.
Oh, yeah. I actually began doing a prison ministry. My friend invited me.
Wow.
Yeah, to this. Here it's locally. We have this. It's called, I forgot the name. It's been a while. But yeah, it was for all men. So it was at first it was a little bit scary because,
sure.
I mean, you're really young and like, so it was one of my first times actually being able to share my music. I didn't really have any songs yet.
Right.
So I was doing a song from like, from the 116 Click.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you did one of their songs?
Yeah, it wasn't one of their songs, and they really, really enjoyed it. And they, I was part of this group, but they were mostly like older people.
Okay.
And they would do like different types of music, and they would do genre, they will make it like Christian.
Right.
So it was like kind of like old school. And I was the only one that would do like a special.
Oh,
so we would do it like every month, I think. But yeah, it was an experience to actually start there and everything, mm-hmm. and just seeing the hunger, you know, for God and everything in there. So. What an experience.
A calling on your life. Wow, at such a young age. That's beautiful. Was it the same prison that you went to once a month?
Yeah.
Okay.
I never did women's though. I maybe one day I can try that, but cool. It was all men. Yeah.
That's cool that you bring up that. I have a connection, and that's what I met this young lady through social media, and that's what she does. She provides material for those who want to go into the prison ministry, you know, the Bibles, whatever she can bring in there, she provides it. So if you ever know of anyone or need anything like that, let me know, because we got to connect.
Okay, yeah, definitely.
We got to connect. Absolutely. So let's talk about your music that you got going right now. How many songs do you have out in Christian hip hop?
I think like about maybe like 14, I think, or maybe less. Something like that. I'm not very sure.
I didn't know that.
Something like that.
Got to do some research and send that music over to me, please. No rush. But yeah, I would love to hear all of it. So let me say, I think I've been following you and listening to your music probably for about 2 years, I think. And then I came across Flawless with you. And tell us about Flawless. Bianca Love. Yeah. Tell us about that and what it means, the title, and share your story about that one.
So that song, it's like it's been pretty long, like old.
Is it
it's
old?
Been a while. Yeah, oh, like wow. Before I put it out.
Oh, gotcha. Okay.
Yeah. It's pretty old before I put it out because I was doing music, like I was performing, but I wasn't really putting out music. Mm. So it was more like performing and not really having music out there.
Okay.
So that was one of the songs that I had, and it talks about like identity issues, you know, like when we're growing up as girls, we start feeling very insecure, like of how we look, right. You know, society tells us like, oh, you need to look a certain way to be the beautiful, right? Mm-hmm. So that's what it talks about. Like, you don't need for men to be telling you that you're beautiful or anything like that, because God made you. You're fearfully and wonderfully made, and you're made in His image. Yeah. And you don't need nobody to be telling you or society to tell you that.
Right.
Having that confidence in you, right, through God. So right. We did that song. It was actually it was an original, and then I got connected with Bianca Love, and we did the remix to it, and then we came up with the video too, which was such a blessing because she's from Florida and I'm from Texas.
Right.
So I had to fly her over here. So yeah.
That's what you did. You flew her to Texas.
Yeah.
Awesome. So, wow, yeah. Man, I love to see Christian hip hop females and how they're elevating their ministry. Because you know, for a long time it was just the guys, you know what I'm saying? And man, I support y'all, you ladies in the Christian hip hop big time. And matter of fact. Another platform of mine, they just posed that question. You know, they're trying to really plug into the females that are doing Christian hip hop, and they're asking a lot of questions, you know, what we can do to help promote you guys more and help y'all out mm-hmm. with your ministry. Have you seen any of that?
Yeah, I feel like it's been growing more and giving more opportunities to ladies because yeah, like you said before, like it was mostly men. It's
yeah.
Like kind of thing, but I'm glad that we're like, I guess, waking up and like seeing like, you know what, God, women can also be used, you know, in this platform.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
And you're sorry. No, it's all good. You're so right because because back in the day, you know, it was frowned on about women being leaders, even being pastors and things in the church. And just recently I heard the gentleman was actually a prophet. And he was talking about how women were used from the beginning of time. You know mm-hmm. what I'm saying? I mean, even if you go all the way back to Mary, you know what I'm saying? I mean, that was ministry. You know what I'm saying? She had to, you know, raise Jesus when he was a child. You know what I'm saying? That was her ministry. So, mm-hmm. you know, oh, man, I'm fired up if you can't tell about this interview. So I was going to go to another one of your songs, but I'm going to skip over that one and then I'm going to come back to it because one of the songs they're featured on with you and she just happens to be one of my favorite and good friends. I got a good question for you. I don't speak Spanish, Espanol, so help me please. Tú me dices, is that the name of the one song?
Yeah, tú me dices.
Tú me dices. Is that the same song with Un Diez a la Vez?
No.
It's two different songs.
Yeah, it's two different songs.
Oh, I didn't know that. That is so good. So which one is the latest?
Un Día a la Vez. I released it this past May, yeah.
You just released that this past May?
Yeah.
Okay, talk about that one.
Well, that was more like a cumbia reggaeton type of song. So it's not very like as much as CHH, I would say, in that genre. It's more of like, I did it more as of my culture. Because when I was growing up, we would listen to a lot of cumbias and a lot of that kind of genre and music in Hispanic culture. That's something that's very out there. I know right now it's been more of what is it, corridos tumbados, like that's been something that's been like popping within the Hispanic Latin culture. Yeah, but this song was it's an actual song from I was researching, and it was actually an English song at first. Wow. And then they made it Spanish.
What does it mean?
It's One Day at a Time.
One Day at a Time.
It's pretty like old school.
Okay.
But I was like, you know what? Like, I've heard this song so many times, like in different, a lot of people do a lot of covers for this song. So I was like, I want to do a remix to it. Like, I don't think I ever seen, I tried looking on YouTube and like different pages to see if anybody had ever made a remix. And I was like, I want to make a remix to this song that's very popular. Mostly like older people know it, like in the Hispanic culture. So I was just like, I have to do it. Like, I just have to do it. It was very kind of hard for me. I had the song the beat for a while, because it goes really fast and it's just like something that I've never done. But I was like, you know what? Like, I feel like God's put this in my heart and I want to take the challenge to do it.
Amen. Yeah. Amen. That one, I'm going to tell you, I haven't heard that one, but I'm excited to get to hear that one. Send it over to me.
You're going to dance with that one.
Yes, that type of tempo, huh?
Yeah. It's like a more like that.
I can't wait. Now, talk to us about the other song, the Tú Me Dices.
Tú Me Dices. Okay. That was a reggaeton song, and it's a full on Spanish song. For that one, it was mostly because last year I went through a lot of hardships. It was like, I feel like I was like Job or something, because it was one thing after the next. It was like, and I was just like, God, like, why is this, all this happening to me? Like, I'm serving you. Like, I'm doing this music for you. Like, I wasn't like being like, God, why? Like, like that. But I was just kind of like concerned, like, why is this happening to me? And God was just like, I'm here with you. Like, I'm here with you. I know this is a hard time, but he showed me that even in the darkest night, he's still the light. Like, he's still there with me. And I was able to go through all that, but it was very hard. So through that, all that hardship that I went through last year, I decided to make a song. And I actually did also a music video to it to link it to some of the things that I went through. So I just released a music video. I think it was last month. Yeah.
Wow. And you have a featured artist on that one?
Yes, I have RMK on it. So he does the chorus part. But what it's saying, the song is like, you tell me who I am, God. Like, you're the one that tells me who I am, not my problems, not all these things that are going around. You tell me who I am, and I can find comfort in that in you. So it's Tú Me Dices, it's you tell me. And that's what it's saying.
So you're telling me, sis, that all of this difficulty time that you was going through, like a Job experience. So you're telling me that God answered you?
Say that again.
You're telling me while you was going through all of this and you asked God, what's going on? Why am I going through this? He answered you?
Yeah, I can say that. Like, it was just a character building as well. Like, I was like, you're gonna come out stronger. Like, you're gonna be refined as gold, like it says on his word. Like, and I really believe that.
Yeah,
because I was able to, I feel like even when you're going through all those hard times, it feels like the Lord is closer to you. So yes, it was hard, but God helped me through it all. I can say that.
How long have you been saved?
I've been saved since I was 17.
Beautiful.
High school.
Beautiful.
The junior.
And been on fire ever since.
Yeah. Like, at first I was like asking God, like, I was like, God, like, what do you want me to do? Like, I know we all have a purpose and we all have gifts but what is mine? Like, I don't know what mine is, you know? And he started showing me that I was able to write, and I enjoy writing. Like, I would write in my journal and stuff like that. And I never knew that I would be able to do music, you know, because that wasn't something that I was like passionately like looking for.
Right.
Like I wasn't. But now that God like revealed that to me, I was able, I'm like, no, this is my thing. Like,
yes.
Yeah.
Yes. And you can, and you can tell that that's your lane. That's your ministry. I've seen some videos and things where you were, I don't like to call them performances because it's not, where you were ministering. There you go. And I can tell your passion, sis. And yeah, God is going to, and I know, yeah, because he just told me he's going to use you greatly. So get ready.
Amen. Amen.
Just like your song, I'm Great. Talk to us about that. Featuring a good friend of mine, V.Rose.
What song
about, sis?
Yeah, so I'm Great. I like, when I came to Christ, I didn't definitely like, it was a lot of growing to do. Mm. I didn't have a lot of confidence in myself, like in talking or anything like that, expressing myself. So I really struggled with that. Right. One of the reasons why that was there was because I came from Mexico when I was 7 years old. I came to the United States. Okay. So it was very hard for me. And I always thought like I wasn't maybe good enough to do anything like great, you know,
right.
Mm. I don't know, like I had to, a lot of learning to do, like English. It was hard for me in school. Like, and now, and I always told myself, I was like, I try to put like a front, kind of be like, oh, I'm not this kind of person that you think I am. And I'm not going to tell you where I'm from. Like, I'm not, kind of like in like a shameful thing.
Right.
At some point. So God started working in my heart and I was able to see that I like, those were all lies. Like, why was I trying to hide? Like, why was I not proud from where I was, where I come from? Like, come why? From. Like, you know, and God, and I kept telling God sometimes, I was like, I wish like I was born here. Like, I didn't have to go through all this struggle. Like, I didn't have to go through all this pain, you know? And I remember reading on his word, I think it's in Luke, where it says that that the angel was telling Zechariah when they were having the baby, John, the prophet, right? It's a prophet. Mm-hmm. John the Baptist. Yes. So he was telling, the angel was telling that he was going to do great things and that he was going to be used. And I remember telling God, I was like, God, I want to do great things for you. Like, I do, like, like, I don't want to keep going through this. And I remember that song. That's where it all started. And I had contacted V.Rose and she had asked me like, oh, like, what are your ideas, you know, and everything. And I told her, like, I want to do something that where people don't feel like they're worthy enough to do great things. Yeah. And I didn't even tell her the title. I was like, I have no title at the moment. So I think it was so awesome how God put that together and she came up with the title. Wow. I had already my verses and everything and she came up with the title. So we were able to, and at first it was a little like through the process of doing the song, like at first I wasn't sure exactly what I wanted, but God was showing me all that while reading his word. So I don't know. I just thought it was so awesome how God, like, she gave me the title. Like, this is the title. This is the song, you know.
And that's my favorite song. It really is. And you know what it is. I was pushing that thing, man. I was pushing it. And I thank you for sending that track over to. And just like you said, that's amazing how God worked that out with V.Rose. And, you know, because like I said, V's a very good friend of ours. We've known V since like 2011 or something like that. Yeah. Wow. She's a very nice young lady and she's been going through, you know, some things too. And absolutely has leaned on God, you know what I'm saying? To help her through those difficult situations that she's been through. Man, what's in the future? You got anything else coming up or are you laying?
Well, I'm currently working on the next single and I want to put out a project like all reggaeton songs.
Oh, nice. Okay.
So that's my next plan. Like I'm working on that and everything. And I'm so excited to show you all like this other side of me.
Sure. Any events or anything coming up?
Yeah, today I have it's such a blessing. And I was just like, oh my gosh, I have an event for a party that I'm going to be singing. I'm going to be rapping, doing music. So I've never been invited to be the special on a, it's called a quinceañera.
I don't know if
you've heard of it. I'm gonna be doing a special there. And I was just like, wow, like, look at God, you know.
God, amen.
Yeah,
amen.
And I do have some other events coming up. We're gonna do, I think it's a sock drive next week. So I'm gonna be performing there too. And yeah, sharing the word. So I'm excited for that.
And did I ask, where at in Texas are you at? What part of Texas?
Well, I'm based mostly in McAllen. I don't know if you know where that's at, or if you know South Padre Island.
How far from Dallas do you know?
Oh, it's like 8 hours.
8 hours from Dallas?
Yeah.
Holy cow. Texas
is a big state. But I'm 4 hours from San Antonio.
Okay. Cool. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. That's Houston.
And Houston is like 5 hours.
Okay. Wow, Texas is big. Whoa.
Yeah. Okay. It takes you like a whole day to get out.
Yeah, to get
driving.
Because I know a few people in Texas too. I know an artist by the name of Blessed. I think.
Oh yeah, Blessed.
Yeah, you know Blessed.
Yeah, is it Joe Santana?
Yes, Joe Santana.
Yeah, that's, I'm gonna be doing the next week's event. It's gonna be with him. Yeah.
Oh, man. And I don't know if he's still doing, but he used to do prison ministry also. I actually think he used to work inside a prison. So
that, yeah, he worked, right, at a juvenile, right? If I'm not mistaken.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Awesome. Yeah, I've known Joe. I'd call him Blessed. I've known Blessed for quite a while too, since like 2015, I think.
Cool. Yeah, he does a lot of outreaches for sure.
Yes, he does. He does. And we're trying to connect in the near future with how do we reach our youth. So we're going to be looking for you to help us with that too.
Let me know. Yeah.
Sure. Well, sis, please let everyone know how they can reach you, your email, all of that, social media, all of that stuff.
Okay. So I'm in all the platforms, Spotify, Apple Music, YouTube, wherever. Mm-hmm. My music is there. You can reach me at Lexly Nirvana in Instagram. I'm also in Facebook, Twitter. I don't do a lot of Twitter. I'm mostly on Instagram. That's usually my main platform, but you can follow me there.
Okay, cool.
Doing in the events, yeah.
Cool. Well, like I said before, we finally got it done, sis.
Thank you.
And myself and the Urban Influencer, we thank you so kindly for letting us interview you. Your boy, DJ Severe, I wish you nothing but the best in your ministry endeavors.
Thank you.
I thank you so much for what you're doing. And most importantly, God does, sis. God does. And he keeps, tears are getting ready to come to my eyes because he's telling me he's going to use you greatly, sis. He's going to use
you. Yeah, that's one of my great desires.
That keeps coming back to me. Wow. So praise God for you. May you have a blessed day, sis.
And
thank you so much, man. We love you. We love you.
Got you
back. If there's anything you ever need, just let me know. Okay. Let me know. All right.
Again, thank you for having me on the show.
You're welcome so kindly. God bless you, Sister Lexly.
God bless you.
God bless. Bye. Bye.
Born on the other side of the border was the place she called home. Few years there she stayed. Then mama told her one day, we can no longer stay and we are moving away. She had to learn a new language and adapt to the new. Little girl crying every night, she didn't know what to do. Estoy a haciendo bien, am I doing it right? Seeking assurance from people. That was the beginning cycle. I was looking for validation from my people. I'm that little girl. The moment I came to Texas, I tried to hide where I came from, thinking no one would understand me. I try to fit in and measure up to other kids, but God makes no mistakes in what he made me or what he made you. He has a purpose, and he loves you so much.
Air in your lungs, you got what it takes. You don't need someone to let you be great. You've got something they can't duplicate. So lift up your head.
Goodbye, bye. It's been long, way too long, and I'm still not strong. Fear flexes on me and tells me, here with me, you belong. In the ground, yeah, quiet down. You got nothing good to say. No one believes in you. You think you'll make it? From the ground, I will rise, because he called me worthy. It's not about what these people think. In him, I would always be worth it. Fear not, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by name, you are mine. When you go through deep waters, I will be with you. The rivers of difficulty, you will not drown. Even through the fire of oppression, you will not be burnt up or consumed. In every step of the way, I am with you.
Air in your lungs, you got what it takes. You don't need someone to let you be great. You've got something they can't duplicate. So lift up your head and have some faith.
Este año fue muy duro, no me quiero acordar. Esos sueños me activan, todo comenzó arriba. Oye, sí me lo creía, pero lo que vino después nadie lo imaginaría. Planes y más planes, tickets y más tickets. No siempre sucede, aunque lo quisiste. Duro fue el momento, me alejé por completo. Las memorias donde dejo yo cayendo, no lo entiendo.
¿Dónde está tu Dios al que tanto le cantas? A visitar otra vez el doctor. Mira tu carita. Flawless, por favor.
No lo entiendo.
Dices que soy yo a ti.
Clama tú al Padre, nunca te dejará, no importa. Fuego, desierto, mar, Él no te arroja. Refinada como oro, yo saldré. Aunque el camino sea fuerte, yo seguiré.
Tú me dices quién soy, yo a ti es quien voy. Tú me guardas, me amas tal como soy. Tú me dices quién soy, yo a ti es quien voy.
Ofrece sí que la quiero, ya con el descuento no se ve muy bueno. Si todo me podrá hacer, me conviene es la pregunta que me debo hacer. When the feelings take over, no te metas en la red. Jesús cuida de mí, no es tiempo y lo sé.
Y es que no hay otro, Dios maravilloso.
que me cuide y me cambie y me llene completamente de su gozo.
You made me. lead me to worry. You did not create me to fear, but you created me to worship daily. So I'ma leave it all right here. Trust in. Trust in you, Lord. I will put my trust in you.
Something happens.